You know, I think one of the hardest things to do when you're pulling spinners is to work kind of sideways to the wind, because the wind always wants to push you off that spot. And I think most anglers at that point say, we just can't fish that spot. We got to go find a spot where we can actually fish and just drift or go with the wind. Problem with that is, you know, you take the spot we're sitting on here today, we've been catching fish here. And now I've got a southwest wind. I haven't seen this wind in 3-4 days. I want to fish this spot. Those fish are still going to be here. So I got to find a way to control my boat, work with the waves sideways, and still stay on the break. Let me show you how I'm doing that. Number one, I'm running my electric motor up front, and I'm able to just keep the boat kind of parallel to the waves, but the whole key to this presentation is actually in the back of the boat, and it's dragging behind us. I've got a 48-inch drift control drift sock dragging back there, and I tie it off of the inside cleat. When I say the inside cleat, the cleat that is facing the wind. Now, if I was on the other side of this structure, we'd be tied to this cleat over here. But what that does is it makes it so that the back end of the boat doesn't get blown away from me, and I've got the trolling motor up front here to hold me the direction I want to go. So I'm able to actually run right along in the troughs of the waves, stay right on that edge where I want to be, and catch fish. Let me show you on the screen here exactly what we're coming up. And you can see I'm trying to just take a straight line right up here, but the wind is actually coming this way. So you can see how straight we've been able to go, though, all the way up this thing along the deep edge. And it's all because of that drift sock hanging off the back right there.